Greetings and welcome to the gallery. I am the curator and the host, Robert Cooper. Now, for those who watched the first episode and left a comment or, you know, gave some feedback and subscribed to this channel, I want to say I thank you from the bottom of my heart. And for those of you who are just tuning in for the first time, here at the gallery, we talk about photography as an art form. Now, we have just concluded February, and as we all know, February is Black History Month. And in addition to acknowledging the accomplishments that Black people have made throughout history and throughout the world, February also is a time where there's a lot of different events going on commemorating and celebrating Black History Month through art. I myself had photos in two different exhibits. One here in Troy, New York at the Center for Photography for their Black History Month celebration, and another one was in Hartford, Connecticut at a show called The People. That one was held at Hartford Art Space Gallery. That one featured mixed mediums from photography to paintings to performance art through hip hop and through poetry. For this episode of the gallery, I chose to speak to some of the other photographers who were featured in these exhibits with me. Here in upstate New York, I speak with Clifford Oliver, a photographer for over 50 years. Now, over in Hartford, I spoke to my good friend Natasha Samuels, who is just now starting out in photography. I also spoke to Maurice D. Robertson, who's been a photographer for about 40 years. And I speak to Jasmine Jones, who claims that she's been a photographer for most of her life. I hope you enjoy what they have to say about their photos and the exhibits that they are a part of.
Black, I've always had a lean toward Black subject matter. I mean, as far as photographs go. I'm a child of the 60s, so I believe Black is beautiful, and I look for that in my images. And a friend of mine said to me she liked my work, and I'm a historian, an amateur historian, and a friend of mine, she liked my work, and she said, you know, I like your work, but you don't do enough women, and the burden of slavery is on the backs of women. And when she said that, literally, this photograph just popped into my head. This image popped into my head, and I was like, I gotta make it. I'd go to Bob Marley concerts and hide my camera under my coat. And usually I went with, you know, with some friends. A friend of mine, Jimmy McIsaac, was a big Bob Marley fan. And he wanted some pictures of Bob Marley. And he said, Cliff, I'll pay your way if you can get some pictures. And I was like, okay. And I said, but we got to watch out for the people walking up and down the aisles, you know, because you can't take photos in a concert. So Jimmy was a lookout guy, and I photographed. And it, yeah, Bob Marley. There was an organization called Black International Black Photographers out of New York City, December of 80, probably the last day of December. And they used to have a, they had meetings, they'd have gatherings. And this one year, I knew Gordon Parks was going to be there. And to go to this party, and it was a New Year's Eve party, you had to submit two pieces of artwork, and they would hang it around. It was in the studio of Tony Barboza. And Gordon Parks, James Van Der Zee, and P.H. Polk were there, and they happened to hang my art piece right above them. So I was in heaven. I was in total heaven. Partied the night away, thanks to Tony Barboza and his world. Models from Vogue, models from all over were there. It was just it was one unbelievable party. And I was glad I was single enough. I was single, I was young, that I had a time. I had a time, one of the best nights of my life. 1977, I was I had fallen on hard times. I had to move back to the city, and I was living in the city, and I went to the Amsterdam News, and there's this woman, Vi Higgins. She put up this little publication, and so she would send me on assignments, and she sent me to the Black Athletes Hall of Fame dinner, and not only Michael Jackson and Tito, Bill Cosby, when he wasn't drugging women, I mean, it was O.J. Simpson. I mean, I got all the bad guys, the good, the bad, the ugly. Who did I get there? It was the most, one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen in my life. Wilma Rudolph. I got photographed with Wilma Rudolph. It was just, yeah, it was a who's who of famous Black people. And they weren't all athletes. I was working for a custom slide house in New York City on Madison Avenue. And one night they sent me out to go get, you know, we work late, crazy photographer hours. And I was the new guy there. I was the gopher. So they sent me out for some Chinese food one night. And I go out, and a huge crowd in front of the movie theater. I didn't think to look and see what movie it was. It was just a huge crowd. I had to weasel my way through. I asked somebody, what the hell's happening here? And they said, Muhammad Ali's here. It's like, oh my God. Oh man, my camera's back at the, you know, back up at the studio. So I went and got the Chinese food, came back, grabbed my camera. Oh, you know, all the, everybody I've been working with, where are you going? I'm like, I'll be just a minute, man. Muhammad Ali's downstairs. So I run back downstairs and the crowd is gone. Everybody's gone. I'm like, oh, damn it, I missed it. And just as I was leaving, Muhammad Ali comes out the door, all by himself. And I just grabbed the shot.
My name is Natasha Samuels, and I'm one of the exhibitors at the People exhibit here in Hartford, Connecticut. I entered a couple of my celebration pieces. They were pieces that I shot at the Taste of the Caribbean Festival last summer, and also the Wadsworth Athenaeum Caribbean Block Party, and also the West Indian Celebration Parade final parade day. I wanted to bring pieces that showed our joy, showed our culture, just showed us just enjoying our Blackness. Photography has honestly been a struggle for me, so to finally see my work upon somebody's wall, I mean, I feel really elated. I mean, I haven't arrived yet, but I'm coming.
My name is Maurice D. Robertson, and kind of haphazardly in the late 70s, I had an Instamatic camera that was very erratic. But I've always had a great love for music, particularly jazz and R&B, reggae. Then in 83, I got my first real camera, Fujica SLR, and I'm from the school of trial and error. So self-taught, area mentors would speak to me about how to improve my technique, and in 2010, I was blessed with a City of Hartford Arts grant, so I got my first digital equipment. And I haven't looked back. I bought a Mac as a result of that grant. I now print my work. I'm getting better with my printing quality, and of course documenting music and nature. I love nature, and I've been able to travel a little bit. So I've been able to, since the 80s, places like Marrakesh in Morocco I've visited. I have wonderful people shots. In 1990, me and my wife went to Egypt with Dr. Ben. I have great shots of the pyramids and the people of Egypt. And since then, just continuing to document the area music scenes, particularly jazz, but I'm very broad in my musical tastes. Reggae, I've got music greats like Third World in the 80s, Gregory Isaacs, Big Youth, for all my friends who remember Big Youth and beyond, and contemporary soul artists, some folks like Prince and so forth.
My name is Jasmine Jones, and I've been doing photography for a long time. It's hard to say, I've been doing it since I was in elementary school. So I have 4 pieces in the show. They are all portraits of some kind, and street photography, because I like street photography. So my focus is on people usually, so I have a lot of pictures of people, a lot of portraits. I think it's great. It gives us a chance to show our work and a way to kind of express ourselves in a space, in a nice safe space.
I thank everybody who watched this episode of The Gallery. Also, if you missed the first episode where I went to New York City to check out the Contact High exhibit at the International Center for Photography, make sure you go back and watch that one as well. And as always, hit the subscribe button and follow me on Instagram at rcooperphotography. Now, I have a website coming up soon too, so be on the lookout for that one as well. I thank you for watching. Blessed love.